start doing, hey, start getting you a towel or something. I don't know, whatever you take on the road, you go right after the player. So you're playing a lot of throw it with this thing in the first year. 2,000 I talked to Nicole, she had to be kind of proud of it to watch the game. It's really good meat for the kit. For the majority of the first half, he had 3 points and 2 sophomores out there. They started to have those kept you in the striking distance before you were the last year.
That's scary, isn't it? 3 freshmen and 2 sophomores. But to be honest with you, our defense was down in the play, but they couldn't open up the lead. So I can't remember exactly. I think we're going to the bench with 12 or 15 minutes left. I mean, Kiki followed, I think it was 7 or 8. And yeah, that's a little unsettling, but as long as you keep your score low, then you guys can really pull away from you. I thought we did a really good job on the board in the first half. Didn't always put the shot back in, or we probably could have been tied, but even a little bit ahead, but I thought we missed some bunnies in the first half.
The team did a pretty good job rebounding, I think it's like 42-44, and a lot of the numbers haven't been getting maybe the last couple of games. They've battled for them down well. We're really at the five back line. At least keeping possession, keeping the clock going. It's a very good game, I'm sure.
That's right, and I thought there were some things we did really well this season. We kept UAB from getting right at the 3-point line. That's how they beat UTEP. They got very, very hot. They were on 2-13-0. But we did a very good job on the boards, and we did a great job on the free throw line. Once we got through that first half, I think they only scored 23 in the second half. And I got to step up here just a little bit. I've been working really, really hard on our kids lately because we know how important winning is. And tonight, we were showing a little bit of fatigue, and it could have been a time where we gave up a little bit. I tried to play really positive with them because I thought we were working hard and we started within weeks, and then boy, all of a sudden, they started trapping, they started honestly going through the ball away a lot tonight in our trapping scenario. That was really good feedback out there because that gives us a lot of energy. But I thought our kids were very calm and composed tonight. They did show a little bit of fatigue, but they played through that. And Nicole and Keith did not show fatigue because they got a lot of rest in the first half. And I got to give Keith for that. He did a very nice job of keeping Amber Jones, one of the best players in the league, in front of us.
Well, you're trying to get it, especially for the year. There's a fight for this game, number 19. They're about 50 in the top. If you're going to start, you're starting to get into the drive. This is the team really starting to hit. It becomes a more game thing about it. It's something that, you know, we talked about the first team the other day. How do you bounce them during the back out of your lane? And this is the beginning. How do you see respond when they come out in the second touch game on the air? The team is out of first place for the preseason ball. The team is playing to get up and do a final lesson. You're nice for it.
That's exactly right, and UAB is a quality team, and all I can say is that we know the quality team to 55 points. We're only giving up 49 points in the top of the season, and we're able to score 63. We talked a lot this week about execution. In the first half, I can't even begin to explain this, but when you have 8 more players on your team, you miss a lot of things. No matter how many reps we get, we do run a fairly complex system, and we did still mess some things up in the first half. And in the second half, I thought we did fewer things. One of the things I tried to do on the bench tonight was I tried to drop everything I possibly could on the board before we went back out, just to give us one final reminder. And I think in the second half, our players communicated better. We started using more hand signals as opposed to just relying on verbal stuff. So it sounds like small details, but if you've only got 4 players out of 5 that know what you're doing, then you can play on your own.